Hey guys, how's it going? It is your main man, main host here at Melodin Friday. I am your host, Mr. LeCrow. Thank you very much for watching and tuning in to this week's episode of Melodin Friday. Now, we have a bit of an international break for the Seattle Sounders. They have the weekend off. However, they're doing international games. We're taking care of some things as well here. So, we couldn't come up with a good Team USA game or a good Seattle Sounders match. So we're going to go ahead and do the next best thing. Since we're having CONCACAF qualifiers going on, we're going to have Canada take on Mexico. And where is this going to take place? It's going to take place at a beautiful BC place in Vancouver, British Columbia. I will not have Team Mexico have the advantage, even though we probably know who's going to win. I am not controlling these. This is a full disclosure. I'm not controlling any of the teams. All right. So, let's finalize several things, get things started now, shall we? It's BC Place here in Vancouver, British Columbia. I'm your host, Mr. LeCrow. Thank you very much for watching and tuning in to this week's episode of Melodin Friday, where I give little to no effort at these broadcasts whatsoever. You know the deal. It's episode 59. So we're doing pretty good here, I guess. We haven't been canceled for low ratings, but hey, you're gonna hear some national anthems. And yes, this is the home of the Vancouver Whitecaps of the MLS, the first MLS stadium in FIFA. So let's go ahead and pause for the national anthems. Clearly, the cameraman doesn't really know how to work these things, but oh well. The Mexican support group making their trip up here to the Canada and Pacific Northwest. Anyways, here's your starting 11 for Team Canada. We're going to be going off in the traditional 4-3-3. Oh, look at that camera guy just pass on by. Oh, I see why Team Canada's tall. Anyways, for Team Mexico, here's your starting 11. We're going to be going on with a 5-2-3 formation. See how that pans out. Of course, here in Canada, you know, it's pretty very small but very strong support group. If you guys follow MLS, you know that they do have a strong contingency between the Vancouver Whitecaps and Seattle Sounders or Portland Timbers. So, Avaristo from Chile will be the one running the man of the match. Appreciating this. We're waiting for the first whistle, and we are underway here on Melodin Friday. Glad you could join us for episode 59. Team Canada versus Mexico. As we take a break from club matches. Oh, it looks like a quick foul here. Is the ref going to the pocketbook? That quick? Looks like he is. Straight yellow card on the third minute. Scott Arfield still arguing about it. Let's take a look at the replay. Couldn't tell from that angle, but Pepe Aguilar doing the did I say Pepe Aguilar? He's doing a good thing here. Selling that foul. Anyways, Miguel Ayun taking a cross near the penalty spot, but no one's there. It's going to be out for Canada goal kick. Let's take a look at that one more time. Oh, that's a sell. That's a sell by Aguilar. That was no foul. Though it depends on whether the ref saw the foul. So then there's the match that we have. Guardado to Layun. Can't control the pass. Kino. Trying to out muscle Henry. Henry now to Johnson. Back to Henry. Looks like Team Canada is trying to find a way to go ahead and find a spot. Djokovic. Back to Henry. Laren to Ole. Oh, nice pass to Laren. Bajong on the top. Crossing it. No, it's over Team Canada. That just sounds out of bounds for Canada's corner. Guzman. He's going to set up for the corner for Team Canada. I think they're right into the hands of Ochoa. Chicharito loses possession. He never really gained possession or a touch there. Henry to Johnson. Mexico's already won their fourth round. They're already in the hex, the final hex for qualification of the World Cup. Larin, no! Bit of a scuffle there. Ricketts inside the penalty area. Had too much power out of that pass. Tries to cross it. Header across the out for the Mexico back line. It's going to be a Canadian corner once again. Second one of the match. De Guzman coming over to set things up here. There's a shot, but no. Henry was chasing it down, but saw that it was going to go out of bounds. He's going to get a Canadian throw. Second ball on the field of play. Rough selling to hold play. There we go. A field to Ole. A field. Cross, but no one's there. Ricketts. Djokovic. Canada is still currently struggling. Dijon back to Djokovic. Canadian team still a bit struggling to continue onto the hex of qualification for the World Cup. It'll be the first time that they appear in the World Cup in decades. It'll be a nice thing for them to go ahead and qualify. Mispossession here. Herrera to Corona. Comes Mexico the other way. Mexico wearing all black. Going from right to left. Canada left to right. Not much action here in the first 30 minutes of this match. A couple of yellow cards. And a corner kick from Canada, but were unable to convert. One yellow call to Arfield for Team Canada right off the bat. Minute 3. Aquino is able to shake off a defender. Gets pickpocketed by Henry. Here comes Canada the other way. Trying to find an opening, but no. Nothing there. They keep going to that right side. Trying to see if they can find something. Now they're switching over to the left. Trying to fake him out, I guess. Here comes Larin. That's what they're doing exactly. Larin, the reigning MLS rookie of the year, to Johnson. Finds Arfield. No, Layun able to pick it up. Layun out to Aquino. Here comes Mexico the other way. It's a 2-on-1 in favor of Team Canada. Now here comes the second man coming up. Corona able to collect the ball. But he gets dispossessed and a collision there. Looks like it's out. Might have been out of bounds. No, it's Canadian ball. Free kick for Canada. You never know what to expect from Team Mexico. That five-man back line really seemed to help him out. Easily dispossessed. But what I mean about that five-man back line, it's basically simple. You know, you got a lot of defenders, numbers in the box. You can't concede goals. However, you do need an offensive power, and I think that's what names like Peralta and Chicharito bring in to this team. Moreno. He's going to go cross field for Corona. But not if you let him shake things off here. He gets him away. Dejong. Edgar. To Johnson. And then finds Ladino. Off the post! Canada scores a goal off the rebound! Man, that was bad timing on my part. There's the shot off the post. And a quick header for Team Canada to find the back of the net. Putting him up 1-0 here in this matchup. And that's... What? The reigning MLS Rookie of the Year scores a goal for his country, putting him up 1-0 over Mexico. 3 minutes of added stoppage time here. Some added pressure for Team Mexico, knowing that they're down a goal. PC Place is slowly starting to rocking. The ref blows the whistle. That'll do it for the end of the first half. It wasn't quite eventful, but then again, we got things picked up here. 1-0 is your scoreline here at BC Place Vancouver. What a crazy and shocking things have come up here in the first half. We'll set things up really quick here for you guys. Just tweet again. As we got the first half underway here. Some quick attacks. That was a quick 3 minute yellow card from our field for Team Canada. If you ask me, it was a bit of a sell point, but hey, the card has been distributed. Hey, look, I didn't even see Edgar's jersey. You know, here comes the shot. That was the one goal off the post. Ochoa quickly trying to come up, but conceding the goal. Canada up 1-0 at the end of one half. Ladies and gentlemen, I am your host, Mr. LeCrow. Thank you very much for tuning in to Melodon Friday. We have a break from the Seattle Sounders action. They're off this week for international gameplay. And Team USA's matches don't have, their opponents are not on FIFA. So we bring you Canada versus Mexico. An interesting tidbit, I am not playing as any team. So I'm still going to get dislikes anyway. So, yeah. Well, we don't really care. It's Miller and Friday. We give little to no effort in these broadcasts anyway. So your scoreline 1-0. Let's go ahead and kick things out. Resume to the second half. In PC Place, in Vancouver. Any minute now, there we go. No substitution for either side. Canada with a 1-goal lead over Mexico. Mexico, very fortunate that goal for Canada was conceded in the 45th minute. Almost conceded a second goal there. It's out for Canada to throw. Dejong gets poked away by Corona. Here comes Corona on the other way. Chicharito Trying to dribble the ball, but he gets pickpocketed. Very uncharacteristic. But in any event, Canada's starting to play defensively. I feel to Johnson. Henri to Johnson back again. He's in midfield, the main man. Trying to set things up here. 1-0 is your scoring line here. In busy place in Vancouver, British Columbia. You can hear the Canadian supporters starting to pick things up here. Pretty rough giveaway. Still manages to cross that. But Ochoa's there to go ahead and pick it up. Trying to do a quick pass at Chicharito, but he is surrounded by his red jerseys. Guzman to Johnson and back to Guzman. Ricketts was trying to do a quick 1-2-3, but unable to capitalize. That pass was too strong. A bad dribbling there. We have a man down on the field. Mexico is coming up here. Herrera. It's at the penalty area. He's going to cross it into Aquino, but he runs out of field. Looks like we have a substitute here. Guzman is coming out. Might have been some sort of injury there at the back end. Team Canada not going to risk it. Sub it off. The Guzman. We have a Mexican sub. And we have another. Canadian off-field will be coming out. Ledgerwood will be coming in. How much can we speculate that this is in fact time wasting? Aguilar to Corona. Rafael Marquez to Moreno. Now Mexico is here trying to play the Canadian game where they try to set up the field, not doing quick attacks. You gotta wonder, Canada's starting to put in some suggested changes. You can see that they've come to a sort of like a 1-4-5 deal, where you got one of the five just coming all over the place. Quick dispossession, ref blows the whistle. Now here comes Mexico with some substitutions. Carlos Peña will be coming in for Hector Herrera. Just waiting for this to resume, and you know, well, they wait. Not that strong of a strong free kick, but I'm pretty sure that was intentional. Corona to Guardado. Johnson almost tackled it away, but unable to successfully do so. There's a bit of mess up right there. Advantage play on. Guardado to Peña. A strong dribble there, but Hutchins able to come off with the ref blows the whistle. Canada gets possession. Final substitution here. Ricketts will be coming out. Petrasso will be coming in. That's Canada's third and final sub. In this match, you can hear some of the boos of the Mexican fans upset. That is, they're being time wasting here. Clock just continues to tick. Come the other way. Guardado. Aquino. To Peña. Try to find some of the players inside of the box. Defense going, oh no, unable to handle it. And that just rolls out for a Canadian goal kick. Such high praises were coming for Team Mexico coming out of this match. And you can kind of sense that one of the reasons is that they already have a good spot for the Hex. And that's okay for them. You know, they don't have to go ahead and battle too much. They can ease it back. But this is also kind of a wake-up call, I'm going to think about it. Think about it, the first week of college football, as we see Corona coming out of the box. Crossing it! Great, sensational save! And it's cleared up in the Canadian back line. Mexico again, trying to come up at it. But no dice here. Usually going back to my theory about how it's like the first game of college football, you try to dim it down, just goes into the hands of Borjan. You set up a good place, get your team accumulated. Get your team accumulated to each other, to know each other, get the feel for it. Then there's several mistakes, you know, you kind of come up with it. I feel that that's what Mexico's starting to do, although they do want to win this match. Or at least draw even. Quick pass to Chicharito! Chicharito with a cross to Peña, but he just goes over the crossbar. Another Canadian goal kick, and they're just going to be wasting time. Now for a team like Canada, they really need a win like this, a good, great powerhouse like Mexico, to give them confidence, see what they do in their qualifying rounds, and maybe they can get some help and go to the Hex for CONCACAF. Mexico's out saying they've already advanced. Trying to sit this out. Get a pressure-like situation like right there and right here. Canadian playing wonderfully here in the back line. Preserving that one goal lead, but Peña picks some pockets. And trying to find a corner so he can cross. And he does so! Oh. Hutchinson picks up the ball from the air and it's just clearing it out for a Mexico throw. Games like these that you want to use Mexico. If you're Mexico, Carlos Peña loses the ball. It's a Mexico throw. You're trying to get back a one goal lead. This is the pressure situations that you need. Aguilar crossing out of the box. Nothing there. Cleared out to the other side. It's still dribbling all over the place. Was played. But Lorian able to get the ball off the hands. 2 minutes of added stoppage time. There's already an early warning, but Chicharito is playing defense here. Mariano is just going to have to kick it out. And that'll do it. That's it. That's the end of the match. Team Canada hosts this match against Team Mexico. Come away with a victory. Canada beats Mexico in this friendly 1-0. Here. A Millionaire Friday. That's a great takeaway from both clubs. Trying to advance to the Hex. Well, Mexico's already advanced, but Canada trying to get good momentum as they proceed on and attempt to go ahead and get into the Hex. Let's take you to some of the highlights in this matchup, shall we? Here at BC Place in Vancouver, British Columbia, the Canadian version of the Pacific Northwest. There's the Pacific Southwest. Here's the early yellow card for our field. 3rd minute of the match. Very debatable, questionable. that talk about Chicharito. I didn't even notice that. Anyway, here's the goal here. Off the post. Larin. Able to insert the header. Puts it in the back of the net. Pass Memochoa for the goal. Canada up 1-0. Then Mexico constantly kept on trying. Chicharito's pass to Peña. Not good. Peña just shoots it over the crossbar. That's as close as they came. And that's it. Your final scoreline here is Canada 1, Mexico 0. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for tuning in. Oops. To this episode of Melanin Friday, where I give little to no effort in these broadcasts whatsoever. It's been fun. It's been a great blast to do this week. Tune in next week. We'll keep it under wraps, but if you already know who it is, then you know who it is. But we'll keep it under wraps. We'll stay back next week where we have Seattle Sounders return to Melanin Friday. But until then, I'm your host, Mr. LeCrow. Thank you very much for watching. Take care, happy gaming, and I'll see you all on the other side. Your final scoreline for BC Place, Canada 1, Mexico 0. Goodbye, everybody.